Hi guys, welcome back. This is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. So this is the moment that we've been working for the past couple hours or days or weeks or however long you've been doing this. I think a lot of you that are watching this have probably spent a lot more time polishing everything and adding all your links and all of that stuff. Let's do this. We're going to publish the site. So the first thing that we need to do is click publish. Sorry, this is just it's a big moment for you, right? If especially if this is your first one, you've gone through all these things together. So I'm excited for you and I would love to have you share back how you do in the comments below, but let's publish. So we're gonna have some options here. So what you'll have is you'll have a site domain that's connected with your domain. So mine is jordandistrict.org. That's the district I work in. So the site will be all of this right here, forward slash whatever you name your site. So I want to say this is probably taken. Maybe not. Oh, it's not. Fantastic. I thought I named that the last site I created. But anyway, so you'll see a little blue check mark here. That means that you're ready to go. There's some words and language that you can't use. Obviously, you can't use swear words, or you can't use like admin or support or human resources or something like that. This is who I can invite to manage my site, and I can change that. So let's go back here again. So I want to go back. Who can view my site? Anyone at jordandistrict.org? Well, that's not really helpful if I want to share this with students and parents. And so the students are going to be covered, right? If they have a jordandistrict.org, but our students have a different domain. And so we need to change this to see who can view this. So I'm gonna click on manage. And what we wanna do is you'll see where it says links. And that's there. I wanna make it public so everybody can see it. So when I click on public, you'll see now it turns green. Anyone on the internet can find and open the site. Now, I also have options for specific links, and we'll talk about that later. We've actually talked about that before. So we're going to click Got It. Then we're going to click Done. Now, right, you have the option here. Do we want search engines to view the site and go through the information? You can request they do not display your site, or you can request that they do. Now, Google is king at this, right, of searching the internet and finding information. For me, this is a resource page. I want teachers from all over the world to come and look at other Google sites that people created, and that's something I'm going to share. I want people to go through the tutorials. I want people to watch the videos. I want people to give me feedback. So I want people to be able to find this site. So I am actually going to leave this open. If you wanted to find out more here, it will take you to another link, and it talks about what this looks like for Google Sites. So we're going to go back here, and the moment of truth, you've probably already done this, but go ahead and click publish. Now what you'll have is you'll have a live link up here. Before, right, I can view the published site, and here's our site. You'll see there is the site, sites.google.com/jordandistrict.org, Mr. Campbell Rocks, slash home. Obviously, when I click on create a site, you'll see that forward slash will change and I'll have a new page. And we can go back and edit the pages and we can do any of that. Now, if you have questions, you should have one. We can change the URL. Let's talk about that in the next video.